So you can find anything on the internet, right? So why is it so hard to find people's email addresses when you need them? Hi, I'm Vince Nero, Director of Content Marketing here at BuzzStream, and today I'm gonna walk you through my 12 tips for finding people's email addresses online. Tip number one, using an email lookup tool. Tools like Hunter or Walla Norbert, they basically use a mix of public data and their own private databases and crawling technologies to help you find and verify an email. Hunter is a free email lookup tool that finds email addresses associated with a specific domain. One feature that I really like is that if you know the website associated and the name that you're looking for, Hunter will actually suggest the most common email format used within an organization. And the other thing I like is that Hunter integrates directly into BuzzStream, and it'll help you search for emails within your prospecting process. Another tool is called Walla Norbert, and this free tool has less features than Hunter, but it gets the job done. Simply enter the person's name and domain, and it will try to search its database and see if it can find it for you. I'll be linking to all these in the show notes, but there's a few other tools out there like Find Emails, Contact Out that do very similar things. All right, tip two is use BuzzStream and integrate it right into your outreach process. So one of the things I always loved about BuzzStream was using the Buzz Marker, which is a Chrome extension plugin. And essentially when you're doing the prospecting, you pop open the Buzz Marker and it will search the site automatically to extract any contact information it can find. This is super helpful because you don't actually need to leave the site and pull up a separate website or tool to find an email address. Tip three is to find and identify the email format. Now, a lot of different sites will kind of group and format their emails in the same way. For instance, ours at BuzzStream is firstname@buzzstream.com. So what you're looking for is the specific format. Now, the aforementioned tool, Hunter, will actually tell you the format, which is super helpful. But if you don't know what that format is and Hunter's not working, then you can actually use something called an email permutator. Now, there's a couple versions of this out there. One of them is called Metric Sparrow. Metric Sparrow's email permutator, you enter the name and it spits out a list of possible permutations. The tool is entirely free. It's actually based off of the work from Rob Ospie, formerly of Distilled, and he has this great Google sheet that's out there and I'll link to in the show notes as well. So maybe you have your permutations or one that you're feeling confident about. The step four is to verify the format. So you can do this with a number of different tools, but quickly to just point out the importance of doing this, the more incorrect emails that you send out, the worse it is for your sender reputation, which can lead to your emails getting marked as spam. So there's two ways to look at this. There are bulk email verifiers, and then you can individually verify an email. So let's talk about verifying in bulk. Typically, they cap the number of free verifications. So I'm going to list a bunch of tools here that you can use and kind of stack the free ones if you want. Obviously, a paid solution is much easier, and these aren't that expensive. For instance, let's look at Bouncer. It gives you 5 free verifications without signing up. And then once you sign up, it's 100 free more if you sign up for just a free account. Their verification tool, as you can see, provided a nice, accurate report of my test email address. A few other verification tools would be Emailable, MailerCheck, Proofy, Snove, and Neverbounce. Now, if you're just looking to verify a single email, you can try one of the tools I actually mentioned before. Hunter allows that, but a few other ones I'll mention here are ZeroBounce, Verifolia, Breadcrumbs, and verifyemailaddress.org. All right, tip number five is going to be using Google search operators. Now, this may seem pretty simple and obvious, but it's very powerful and it's one of my go-to solutions if I'm not feeling like using a tool. So a few of these search operators will be looking on the site itself, something like site colon website name plus the name of your contact plus the word contact or plus the word email. If you only know their name and not the website, look for terms that someone might use in an author byline like email me or contact. Tip six is going to be finding email addresses from social platforms. Now, it can be very easy to get lost in a rabbit hole of social, so I'm gonna break it down into different platforms for you. So to find an email on Facebook, you're gonna wanna look either on their main profile page, or where I typically see it is under the About tab. To find an email address on LinkedIn, simply go to the contact info section of their profile page. To find an email on X, aka Twitter, you can go to the advanced search page, which is not easy to find, so I'll add the link in the show notes. But basically, you enter the account of the person you want to search, and then in the words section, use words like Gmail or contact me or email me or write me. This advanced search is going to uncover tweets where someone has actually said some of these phrases and included their email address. To find someone's email address on YouTube, you'll be able to find it on their channel page in the About section, though it's a little hard to find. So if you're having trouble locating it, go to the profile page and click on the arrow next to the sentence that appears below the channel title. Then you'll see an About page pop up, then click on View Email Address, which will further prompt you to verify that you are not a robot. Okay, and tip number 7 is ask a company's site chat. So many brands will have a little chat box that you'll see at the bottom right hand of the screen. Click on that. You want to say something like, hi, I'm looking to speak with the blog writer or the person who heads up the blog or the editor of the blog. You could try something more general like the person who runs marketing for the site. So tip number 8 is to ask someone on social media. So if you can find their social media, get friendly. This tactic is essentially the same as the chatbot, but you're going to message them and ask them to try to connect. If it's an individual person, try to follow them, interact with them on social before you're actually DMing them or messaging them on a platform like Facebook or something. We found that if you get into their emails or get on their radar first before you're asking for an email address, it's going to be a lot easier. It lowers that barrier of entry. And be selective on where you look and reach out for certain people. B2B brands are probably more active on X or LinkedIn, whereas B2C brands might be more active on platforms like Instagram or Facebook or X. Tip number 9 is to search the company's website itself. So you're going to want to look on About Us pages, contact pages. If you can't find the contact on any of those pages, try a site search. So the word site, colon, and then the website name, and then search words like contact or email us. Note that if you're looking for journalists, publisher sites typically have email addresses listed on a team page or an about page or an author page. Okay, tip number 10 is to subscribe to a company newsletter. Now, the smaller the newsletter, the better. And typically, when you subscribe to a newsletter, you're going to receive that letter from an actual email address. And with smaller newsletters, like I said, you'll find that it's typically an actual person that's sending out these newsletters. Then you can just strike up a conversation, let them know you love the newsletter, let them know you're trying to get in touch with them. Tip number 11 would be to check relevant directories. Now, we're getting to the bottom of the barrel here, but sites like Crunchbase or Better Business Bureau, these are big directories that have a lot of information. You're going to find more generic email addresses at this point, but it's better than nothing. And sometimes you can ask those generic email addresses to get put in touch with the person you're looking for. Okay, and the last tip here is number 12, and that's sending to the generic company email address. So this is going to be something like info at, or maybe company at the website name. Now, keep in mind that since we're at the very bottom of the barrel here, these types of emails addresses tend to get contacted by everybody and anybody. They're the generic email address that you use for signing up for, you know, different tools. And so they're going to have a lot of noise in there. So if you don't hear back right away, don't get discouraged. Try again. Do something to try to make your email stand out. This can be fruitful, especially in smaller websites where maybe there are people actively monitoring a generic email address for the company. So like I said, don't get discouraged. Try them out. Okay, if you made it this far, I've got some special tips for you. And these are how to find email addresses based on the prospect type. So here's some patterns I've noticed throughout the years. DIY, parenting, lifestyle, beauty bloggers. Most of these types of bloggers who don't list their email addresses on their websites, they'll list them on Facebook. Tech bloggers or business, B2B space, finance. If someone's active on this space, it's sometimes hard to find their email addresses on their website, but You will have some luck if they are active in guest blogging. So in each case, you can use search operators in Google to find them. Here's a Google search that uncovered a post I did on Ahrefs. Okay, if you're doing outreach to freelance journalists, if you can't find their email address on the site that they're writing on, a lot of times they'll have their own portfolio websites and they'll list their emails there. Look out though, because sometimes they'll spell it out instead of using the at sign. So they'll put at in parentheses or dot in parentheses. So you might have to do some actual digging to find it. It might not work if you just do a site search for their email address. Okay, if you're looking for an in-house journalist, a lot of these journalists will actually want your tips and they'll put their email right into something like their X profile or author byline that you'll see right under their picture on X. All right, and the last subsection here is the government sites, libraries, schools, the resource page outreach that you might be doing. Most of them are going to be covered by a webmaster, and a lot of times you can find that webmaster at the very bottom of the page itself, like in the footer somewhere. It'll say to contact the webmaster to make changes on this list, contact here. All in all, don't be afraid to use tools out there. That's what they're there for. They're going to streamline the process. Use Hunter, integrate it with BuzzStream, get your Chrome extensions going, and you'll find that finding email addresses is going to be way easier. Thanks for watching. If you like what you see, please give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think in the comments and subscribe to our channel for more tips like this. Thanks.